supraventricular tachycardia. And this is must be differentiated from the ventricular tachycardia. The wide complex supraventricular tachycardia is maybe regular or irregular. This is the regular. The regular can be resulting from bundle branch block, which is either old bundle branch block pre-existed or new functional and transient bundle branch block. This sinus rhythm with LVH, and this the patient, it is came with left bundle branch block, wide complex tachycardia. And this the basic sinus rhythm after the tachycardia. This is with apparent conduction during the increased heart rate and then return to normal after the heart rate return to normal. Commonly, in normal healthy heart, the bundle branch block can result from the right bundle branch block, because right bundle branch block have increased the refractory period. There it is blocked, and the activation of the ventricles, it is coming from the left side, producing right bundle branch block morphology with apparent conduction. And this is the sinus rhythm, also sinus rhythm with wide complex tachycardia. Why called here sinus rhythm? Because the B wave and inferior leads are upright, but here it is AB nodal reentrant tachycardia or junctional, because the B wave, it is inverted in inferior leads. And other form of that causing wide complex tachycardia, it's the activation of the ventricle from eccentric side, from the lateral side, like this. If the accessory pathway and antidromic conduction is going through this and activate the ventricle from this side, producing eccentric activation of the ventricles, either from the left or from the right side, and producing antidromic wide complex tachycardia, which occur severely wide or hugely QRS complex and regular. In the normal sinus rhythm, we will detect the pre-excitation. Another form, it is this left bundle branch block wide complex tachycardia, but it is regular. This atrial flutter with fixed block activated the ventricle from eccentric, from the right side, from here, activated through the accessory pathway and produce left bundle branch block wide complex tachycardia through accessory pathway. And this is the left bundle branch block, but irregular. This atrial fibrillation from the supraventricular, it is activated the ventricles from the right side, but it is irregular because atrial fibrillation. This is atrial flutter with fixed block. The atrial fibrillation, it is chaotic, abnormal electrical stimulation of the both atria or one atria, but in a random way that is attached to the any accessory pathway and then conducted down, producing irregular wide complex tachycardia. And this is the accessory pathway, posterior lateral left posterior accessory pathway. In this delta waves inverted in inferior leads because it's in posterior side, that mistakenly interpreted as my inferior wall myocardial infarction, and the patient admitted to intensive care unit. After that, the patient developed wide complex tachycardia with irregular, grossly irregular. That's maybe atrial fibrillation with an abnormal conduction through the accessory pathway, and you have to concentrate on this. And this is the atrial fibrillation also with accessory conduction. This produces irregular QRS complex in each lead, from beat to beat, the QRS complex irregular in the width and amplitude. That is mistakenly interpreted as polymorphic ventricular tachycardia, or should be differentiated from polymorphic ventricular tachycardia and from other abnormalities and or from the apparent conduction. This is atrial fibrillation with apparent conduction that producing right bundle branch block pattern that activated the ventricles from the left side, because the right bundle branch is blocked. Thank you for your listening.